Where am I? What happened? Oh, my brother, you were so close. I swear I will find you.
Do I ask too much of her?
Time again will tell.
White peacock! What can it mean? What are those creatures that chase it?
But see, Randa has the soldiers under her spell.
A fresh mortal at the gate? Greetings, little fly. Welcome to my web.
And Raji can grow more, if only she thinks of it.
Vishnu.
It was demons of Randa in my city.
The shadow is long.
You must feed them, Raji.
She cannot hear you, but she knows what to do. Slaves to Ranga. Oh, my Raji. Avoid their gaze. Gives her a chance. But the way is blocked. Look, the Gajan waters are high.
There are chasms to lower them. But what does she know of cocks and weeds?
She is clever, the sir. She will find a way.
Thank you.
insurgents of Hiranya. They are restless. Something is wrong.
Randa has granted.
Have no mother, no father.
They are up there, in the stars, little brother.
Thank you. The gods are with me.
This is the place of sun, the mills, the water that feeds the green fields. There is no denying it is clever, Vishnu. It is such a concentration of power. And now it is in Randa's hands.
The gods stand on my
These people have no will. Their minds are clouded by Randa's shadow. And so the city was taken without any way to fight back.
But they are alive, and so they can be freed. Saying that she would be a slave to Gudru until her second egg hatched. And if she did not show patience with that hatching, she would forever be a slave. And so, under the curse of a half-formed offspring, and through the machinations of Gudru and her Naga children, Vita became a slave to her sister. Years passed until one day Vita's second egg finally hatched. From it emerged Garuda, the king of birds. Seeing his mother's servitude, Garuda asked the Nagas to free her. They agreed, but on the condition that Garuda would fly to heaven and fetch for them the elixir of immortality. Garuda, for his mother's sake, flew to the heaven of the Devas. He was too powerful for the Devas to defeat, and so seized the elixir from them. I saw that Garuda did not want the elixir for himself, and so I manifested myself to him. Because his heart was pure, I granted him the gift of immortality. In return, he granted me the gift of becoming my mount. Should I so desire it, I warned Garuda of the deceptive nature of the Nagas. So Garuda returned to the Nagas with the elixir, but tricked them, telling them that it could only be consumed after they had purified themselves in the holy river. He attacked them unsuspecting, as they bathed and ate them up. He freed his mother, Vidita. For safekeeping, Brahma took the elixir and bore it back to the heavens.